Hey, it's John at Enduring Charm. You know, as a professional remodeler, I own pretty much every type of power saw that there is. However, hand saws are something that I do turn to from time to time. For small jobs, it can sometimes be easier to grab a hand saw than to set up a power saw. So in this video, I'm going to go over some of the common hand saws and their uses. Now, one of the most common hand saws is the Crosscut hand saw. Now, this comes in a whole bunch of different sizes, different teeth configurations and all that, but they all basically look the same here. Triangular shape, the teeth are oriented away from the user, and it usually has a wood handle. Sometimes they're plastic, but it's something substantial to hold on to. It has a little bit of flex to it, and this is used for cross-cutting wood, and it's as old as the hills, and still very effective, especially if you just have one or two cuts to make. Now, the box saw is another common saw, and it is normally associated with a miter box like this, hence the name. The miter box has slots cut in it. It could be made out of wood or, in this case, plastic. And those slots help you orient the blade correctly, in this case, for a 45-degree angle or a 90-degree angle, and it helps you stay accurate. Now, these are still available and very inexpensively, actually. It has teeth that are, again, are oriented away from the user, and the cut, just like the cross saw, is on the push stroke rather than the pull stroke. It normally has a piece of metal on top here, like a spine, to help keep it stiff. So this blade doesn't have a lot of flex to it like the Crosscut does. Now, these are several dovetail saws. If you get into woodworking by hand, very often you'll need to cut dovetails like this in a drawer or a box or something like that. And these dovetail saws are designed to help you do that. You notice they're very short, and they have a very stiff spine up top here. This style also has a spine here. And that keeps the blade very stiff so it doesn't flex on you and allows you very good accuracy. The teeth, again, are oriented away from the user. However, there are very fine tooth on there, so you can cut very, you know, accurately. I prefer this style actually over this style, but either one is called a dovetail saw. Now, these are all examples of the Japanese pull style saw. And these are different because the teeth are oriented towards the user. And that means you cut on the pull stroke rather than the push stroke. So Western saws, you generally cut on the push stroke. Japanese style saws cut on the pull stroke. And these do have a lot of flex to the blade. However, they could be very accurate because you are cutting on the pull stroke. Therefore, the blade stiffens up as you pull it through the cut. And they're very accurate in that sense. These are three different types. This one's for woodworking. This one is actually for cutting PVC pipe and things like that. And this is a style that has two different types of teeth, one on this side, one on this side. But again, it's both of them cut on the pull stroke. So Japanese pull saws are something I use very often. I keep several of these on the truck and the trailer because they come in very handy for just quick, accurate cuts. Now, the coping saw, used generally to cope moldings, sometimes used for other purposes as well, is another specialty saw, but a lot of people are familiar with it. It has a frame that's very wide in relation to the blade. That allows the workpiece to come up in here and allows you maneuverability. And the blade has the teeth oriented towards the user, but it's also a very thin blade, so it allows you to make very tight curves as you're coping molding. So a very useful saw, something I use all the time, and I keep at least a couple of them on the trailer. Now, the hacksaw is another very common one. Most people have one in their shop somewhere, used for metal cutting generally. And this blade is replaceable, so it's easy just to unscrew this and replace it because it gets worn out pretty quickly when you're cutting metal. There's all sorts of blade configurations you can buy, but again, one of those saws that pretty much everybody has and you'll need from one time or another. Now, this is a flush cutting saw, and it's called that because it allows you to put it down flat on a surface, and let's say you have another piece of wood adjoining that surface, you can cut flush. And this allows you some space for your hand so you don't wrap your knuckles while you're cutting. This particular one also has a handle here for two hands. Some of them have teeth that are oriented only one direction, and that allows you to cut right on the flat surface without scratching that surface. This particular one does not, but some do. So if you had a door jamb that was adjoining a floor, for example, you could use this to cut that door jamb if you needed to, and things like that. Now, this saw is kind of an oddball. It's a tile cutting saw. And the blade, if you want to think of it that way, is really just a, it's kind of a cable, and it's got an abrasive on that cable. So it cuts in either direction, and it allows you to cut some tile, not porcelain tile very well, but ceramic tile certainly. It's not something I use very often, but they do exist. So with all our obsession with power tools, I think it's good to be reminded that hand tools can be very useful as well. And these are some of the saws that I will use, and especially the Japanese pole saw, the dovetail saw, and even the crosscut saw are something that I use, you know, on a weekly basis for sure.